back for 60 years,
right.
They would like to sell their stake and get out. So that time we have the first right of refusal, and is likely we will take over that stake in appropriate time.
Well, let's shift focus now and put the spotlight on Great Eastern Energy. Prashant Modi, President and COO of the company, joins us now. Prashant, thanks so much for joining us. A quick heads up on the company, of course, for our viewers. Great Eastern Energy operates coal-bedded methane projects in India. He's invested about 800 crores in Raniganj block, and it's investing another 2,000 crore rupees for drilling. What's the outlook from here, Prashant? What are the expectations and what can investors really expect from the company?
Well, as you know, we are the first commercial CBM company in India. We have been selling now for about 3 years, and recently, about 10 days ago, in the recently concluded CBM fourth round, we were awarded a second block in Tamil Nadu, the Mannargudi block, which has an effective area of 667 square kilometers, which translates to about 170,000 acres. So the outlook is we are developing the current field, which is the Raniganj field. Currently, we are at about 3.6 to 3.7 million cubic feet per day of production, all of which, after internal consumption, is being sold to various industries. And we will continue to develop this block. It will take another 5 to 6 years to fully develop it. It requires an approximate 300 wells. We have drilled about 75 wells, and about 30 odd wells are on production. And as you might be aware, we are in the entire value chain from the upstream, midstream, downstream. So from the time we produce till the time it reaches the burner tip of the customer, it is controlled by Great Eastern. And the outlook remains very positive. We are confident. The production rates and the results we are getting are as per expectations or exceeding our expectations. And now the new block, we will start exploring once all the approvals, etc.
Yeah. Well, what is the ramp-up plan going forward in terms of production as new wells get developed? Can you share with us any numbers?
Well, you know, eventually, I can't share with you a yearly sort of a number, but eventually, once the full field is developed, the Raniganj field, in the next 5 to 6 years, the production would cross 100 million cubic feet. It would be between 100 to 120 million cubic feet. Going forward from this block alone, and we have to still explore on the Mannargudi block, but the expectations are that once that is also fully developed and explored, it will also produce in the region of 100 million cubic feet.
A quick understanding of your financials. You did post a $7 million pre-tax loss, and then you also have a little bit of a component of debt, about $35 million in debt. By when do you see the, you know, the business break even, and how do you see the financials panning out?
Well, the business has already broken even, and if you look at the numbers of this first quarter, which were announced on July 19th in the London Stock Exchange, so the company has broken even on a EBITDA level and also covering the interest now. So on a revenue basis, the company is cash positive, and going forward, the company has enough funds in hand to develop the block, and the future expansion will be met through internal accruals, which will be more than sufficient to fund the operations.
So you're not looking at any kind of money raising plans right now. You're adequately funded for the kind of expansion that you're talking about.
Yes, currently we are not, but you know, once we start exploring the new block in Mannargudi, and depending on what kind of results we get and how fast we get them, at that time, if there is a need, we will we could look at raising some money at the appropriate time.
And what kind of means would you use to raise this money, and what kind of quantum would you have in mind if you have to develop a whole new block?
Our minimum commitment for the minimum work program is in the region of about $20-21 million, which has to be basically as for the commitment spent over about 5 years. So if, say, if you start developing that block from the end of next year, that takes us down to 2015-16. And As I said, depending on the results, we could look at a $50 to $100 million raise at the appropriate time. But you know, then again, it's, you know, in oil and gas, it depends on what you, what the results dictate your investment. So we will, depending on the results, we will look at the most effective, cost-effective method for raising capital, whether it's equity, a mix of equity and debt. That will be decided at the appropriate time.
Okay, Prashant, thanks so much for joining us. That's Great Eastern Energy for you. Listed at the AIM exchange, has broken into the black, and of course has ambitious plans going forward. Moving on now, the big news coming in is that after just over a month after petrol prices were hiked, fuel retailers are set to raise prices yet again. My colleague Kumardeep Banerjee joins us for more. Kumar, no big surprises there now that petrol has been deregulated and crude oil prices have been ramping up. What kind of a quantum of increase are we looking at, and by when?
Well, ideally, it should have been in the month of July itself, but given that the parliament is in session and we have seen many the way the government, the opposition, or the government has been cornered by the opposition over the huge inflation.